Hello, my pre-calculus student. The objective for this video is solving system of linear equations using augmented matrix. Now, what we have been doing so far, that we're looking at it is a system of linear equations with three unknowns, x, y, and z. And let's look at this system. We equation has three equations, and we have three unknown x, y, and z. The first equation is x plus y plus z equal 1. Now, when you write this, a system of equation in term of augmented matrix. So the first equation now become, I'm looking at the coefficient of x, y, and z, which is 1, 1, 1, and the constant is 1, and we draw a line to separate between the variable and the constant, or this line can also represent the equal sign. We move on to equation 2. We have negative x plus y plus z equal 5, should be negative 1, 1, 1, 5. And equation number 2, we're missing x, we have to put the 0 for x, 1 for y, and then 2 is the coefficient for z, and the constant is 5. Now let's review quick to describe the location of one number inside our matrix. We have to start with the row first and then the column. For example, if I look at this augmented matrix here, if I say row 1, column 1, the number is 1. Or if I look at this number, with row 2, column 1, the number is negative 2. Now, next, let's mention about the goal. So the goal is that we want to apply the row operation to obtain row echelon form. So what is it, the row echelon form? This is how it looks like. You can see right here that you only see 1 and 0 on the left hand side of the line, and 1 has to stay in the main diagonal. On the right hand side of the line, you will see real number. So from here, from the row echelon form, you can conclude that your solution is the triple points x equal a, y equal b, and z equal c. Now so far we solved the system of linear equation with three unknown, but we have not shown you how it represents this on the graph. So let me just show you quick the graph how it looked like. So you can see right here that we have three equations, and each equation has three unknowns. So this is a three-dimensional graph. So you have three plans. So I'm going with equation 1, equation 2, and equation 3. Each equation you have a plane. So where all three planes intersect at one single point, that point will be the solution. So in this case, I make a note here, this will be your solution when we label x, y, and z. And now job with that, we try to find the points where all three planes intersect. So go ahead and draw this picture and write this note to your notebook before we go back. Now let's continue to solve this system of equations. So now we know our augmented matrix, and we already set our goal. So let's start with the first one. We want to get a 1 in row 1, column 1. So row 1, column 1. And we compare with our augmented matrix. Of course, we do have a 1. Okay, next step. Now the rest of the column 1, we want it to become a zero, and we also have one of the zero in row 3, column 1 down. So we just need to make sure this number become a zero. So to make it become a zero, we will have to take row 1, which is 1, plus row 2, and put it back in row 2. So I'm going to go ahead and write a note now. Row 1 stays the same, so we copy row 1, which is 1, 1, 1, and we draw the line. I put 1. So this is row 1. Row number 2, we have to take row 1 plus row 2, that will be the new row 2. So think about 1 plus negative 1 is 0. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 5 is 6. Now row number 3, it does have 0 already. We don't have to do nothing. We just copy it back to 0, 1, 2, 5. So now you can see right here that we all have column number 1 all done. Let's move on to column number 2. So column number 2, we want to get 0, 1, 0. So you can see right here that we don't have a 1. In column 2, row 2. So we want to get a 1. Now there are more than one way you can do it. You can go ahead and divide every single number in row number 2 by 2 to get a 1. Or you can go ahead and move your row 2 into your row 1. Either way it works. So what I'm going to do right here, I'm going to take row 2. I'm going ahead and divide by 2 and put it back into row 2. So that will give me the 1. So row 1 stays the same, so I'm going ahead and copy row 1. So which is 1, 1, 1, 1. Row number 2, we divide by 2, so 0 divided by 2 is just 0. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 6 divided by 2 is 3. And row number 3, we just copy, so back at the same as the previous matrix. So we have 0, 1, 2, and 5. So now we have 1 in row number 2, column 2. Next step, we want to guess a 0 for the rest of the column 2. So we're based on row number 2. So to get a 0 on row 1, column 2, we will have to take row 2 minus row 1. That will be the new row 1. So let's write it down. 0 minus 1 is 1. Oh, sorry, negative 1. Sorry. So 0 minus 1 is negative 1. So in case you want, we can write it down and we can erase. So 0 minus 1 give us negative 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. 3 minus 1 is 2. So now you have your new row 1. Your row number 2 stays the same, so just copy the dash. It'll be 0, 1, 1, 3. Now your row number 3, you want to get a 0. So you're going to take your row 2 minus your row 3. That will be the new row 3. So row 2 minus row 3 should be 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. 1 minus 2 is negative 1. And then 3 minus 5 is negative 2. So now you can compare with your augmented. Now you can compare with your row excellent forms. You can see that you do have 0, and you also have 1 in your row 2 column 1. Now you can go back and look at your column number 1 here. You can see, oh Lord, I do need to make it become a 1, not negative 1 yet. We can do it last, so don't worry. Now next step, we're going to move on to column number 3. So in column number 3, we need to make sure that we do have a 1 in row number 3, column 3. So I'm going to talk about row 3, column 3 right here. We need to get we need to make it become a 1. So we don't have a 1 right here, we do have a negative 1. So what are we going to do is we'll go ahead and divide. So we'll take row number 3 divide by negative 1 and put it back in row number 3. So now you will get 0 divided by negative 1 is 0. 0 divided by negative 1 is 0. Negative 1 divided by negative 1 is 1. 2, negative 2 divided by negative 1 is 2. So now we have 1 in row 3, column 3. Then I'm copy the rest. So I'm copy my row number 2, 0, 1, 1, 3. You just look right on your left hand side the previous matrix, negative 1, 0, 0, 2. Okay, so now the next step we're going to do is that we need to match we need to make sure that every single number in column number 3 except row 3, column 3 have to be 0. So we do have a 0, but this one we do need to make it become a 0. So I'm going to go ahead and write it down. So first of all, when you copy row 1, stay the same. So row 1, put negative 1, 0, 0, 2. Now for our row number 2, column 3, we need to become a 0. So to do that, based on row 3, we take our row 3 minus our row 2 and put it in row 2. So 0 minus 0 is 0. 0 minus 1 is negative 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. And 2 minus 3 is negative 1. And we copy our row 3, which is 0, 0, 1, 2. So now we go ahead and compare with our row epsilon form to see if we have everything we want. Yet we do have the 0 that's not on the main diagonal. But we need to go back and we need to make sure that we do have a 1 on the main diagonal. So let's take care of these two here and then we will be done. So now this will be, let's start with row 1. So row 1, so to get this, now this negative 1 become 1, I have to divide by itself. So row 1 divided by negative 1, that will be the new row 1. And let's write it down. So the new row 1 now will be 1, 0, 0, because 0 divided by whatever is still 0, whatever number. 2 divided by negative 1 is negative 2. Now let's move on to row 2. Row 2, again, we want this number to become a 1, so we'll have to take row 2 divided by negative 1, which is itself to get a 1. So we have 0, 1, 0, 1. Row 3, we don't have to do nothing with this, so we copy it down 0, 0, 1, 2. So therefore, from here, we can conclude that our solution is the triple portion. This time, we'll go ahead and write them at a triple, at a pair of triple. So this point have three values inside because this is a three dimension. So the point be x, y, and z, and where x is negative 2, y is 1, and z is 2. Thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to write your own summary. Goodbye.